baseball for you from Guaranteed Rate Field on the south side of Chicago. Tonight, we've got a good matchup in store between the New York Yankees and the Chicago White Sox.
And now, your Chicago.
Stay tuned. White Sox baseball is next. Ready now is DJ LeMahieu. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. Hit the other way out toward right field. And Mendick will be there. There's one away. One out, base is empty. And that'll bring up the former American League Rookie of the Year, Big Aaron Judge. And it's a ball and two strikes now to Aaron Judge. Weather not much of an issue tonight. A mild 65 degrees here at game time. Check swing grounder to the right side. Throw in time as he's called out on a bang bang play at first. Now to the plate, Joey Gallo. The 1-1 home. Takes a pitch for strike number two. Hangs on him a bit that time as it's belted out toward deep center field. Gone!
What a way to get things started while playing on the road. Top of the first and a big fly just like that, and they take the lead.
Into the box, Giancarlo Stanton. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Got a piece, it's 2-2.
Hey, that was a nasty pitch right there. Ton of rotation on that ball. You could almost see the red dot from up here. Nasty depth.
And it's fouled away. Grounded weakly down the line toward third, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Now the pitch. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
Hey, this guy's a hard guy to put away. He's fouling off some.
But we'll have to press pause as that strike three to retire the side. And that'll bring up the shortstop, Tim Anderson. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Now here's the pitch. He stays alive, still 2-2.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
Hit in the air down the right field line. Judge is on the move. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning. Digging in, the switch hitter, Cesar Hernandez.
Cesar Hernandez.
The 1-1.
2-1.
Jose Abreu will be next. The 3-1 pitch. Count full, three balls and two strikes. And the payoff pitch. Fouled off. The payoff pitch one more time. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Stepping in next, Jose Abreu. Lifetime against this pitcher. He's just 2-for-9. Hit sharply on the ground. Torres picks it up. Throw in time, and the side is retired. And that'll bring Anthony Rizzo to the plate as it'll be 5, 6, and 7 due up to kick off the second inning. The 1-1. Here's a fastball in on the fist, and that'll even things up at 2-2.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
That is good.
Yankees lead this 1-0 here in inning number 2. To 2-2 now. And he fouls this one off. The 2-2 one more time. Bounce towards the second baseman. Throw on to first, two gone. Base is empty, two away, and that'll bring up the exciting middle infielder, Gleyber Torres. Fouled away. Swing and a miss, and that's out number 3. Last half of the second set to go, and that'll bring up the former top prospect as a minor leaguer, Yoan Moncada. The 1-1 home.
Sitting in a good spot right here. 2-1 count is yet to see a fastball. Have to be sitting on one right here.
2-2 now.
Well, somebody's sitting off speed right here. Only way he was late on that heater is he was expecting another changeup.
Breaking ball swung on in the dirt. Up with it, Sanchez. He'll throw down to first, one away. So bases are empty with one out now. And up next, the exciting Eloy Jimenez. Now the 1-1 pitch. Strike 2 swinging.
I know that fastball registered at about 92, 93, but I guarantee you it looked about 4 to 5 miles an hour faster than that for this offensive player. After coming off a curveball, the old push the throttle and pull it is being used.
The count is full, 3-2 to the White Sox DH.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Hit high and deep out to left center field. Gardner going back. A leap at the wall, but he can't bring this one back. It's a home run.
Man, you could see the center fielder tracking the ball the entire way. He thought he had it, and he might tell you he should have had it, but he just couldn't bring it back into the yard. Sometimes it's a game of inches, folks.
Standing in now, Danny Mendick. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. The next 3-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Bases are empty here with two away. And up to the plate next is Andrew Vaughn. The 1-1. Good opposite field power here, taken high and deep to right. And he gets there, makes the running play, and that ends the inning. That'll bring in Giovanni Urshela as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. And there's a fastball well off the plate inside.
You do not want to walk the 8-hole hitter. It just opens up so many options. Do we bunt them over to second with the 9-hole hitter? Do we try and play for that big rally with the top of the order coming up? This is a huge pitch. You can't allow this guy to walk.
And another foul ball. And he lays off there, ball 4. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number 3.
Batting none.
Now to bat, Brett Gardner.
Brett Gardner.
Down low, 2-1.
Sometimes you got to be aggressive offensively, but sometimes you just let the pitcher dig his own grave. Patience and discipline seem to be the way to go right here.
Ball even at 2-2. 3-2 to the Yankee center fielder. And boy, that misses as well. It's back-to-back walks to start out the inning. Next to hit is DJ LeMahieu, 0-for-1 here in the early going. Swing and a liner. That's in there. Base hit. And no sense risking anything here as the bases will be loaded now with still nobody out. Stepping in now, Aaron Judge. Fastball, and it gets by him, a swinging strike. Fastball, strike three called on the outside corner, and a pretty generous corner at that, as that's the first down of the inning. Urshela, the runner at third. Gardner at second. LeMahieu is over at first with one away. And this could be trouble now. It's 3-1.
Hey, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, that's right where you want to miss. Any lower, and he'll probably make you pay for it.
Oh, and it misses. Ball four, and that will force home a run.
The designated hitter, Giancarlo Stanton.
1-1, here it is. And that fastball's too much for him there. 1-2.
I mean, he's coming right after him, Matty. Three fastballs in a row.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
So he racks up the swinging strikeout on the breaking ball. Giancarlo Stanton goes down for out number two in the top half. And it's fouled away.
That's a real nice location with that fastball up and in on the hands. Hard to do much with that because a hitter really can't extend his arms very easily.
A dive and he knocks it down. And they will still manage to get him at first. A spectacular all-around play and the inning is over. Bottom of the third now. And next to bat will be the outfielder, Brian Goodwin. The 1-1 is taken for ball two. All even now, 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Not close with the off-speed pitch taken for a ball. Zach Collins is on deck. Fouled off. Another full count pitch home. And good patience exercised as he works out the walk to lead off the home half of the third.
Batting ninth.
Next to stand in is Zach Collins.
Collins.
The 1-1. Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out.
Number seven.
And the next to bat will be Tim Anderson. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far. Oh, look at that stop. Torres at the bag. On to Rizzo, and it's a double play. Side retired. Set for the start of the fourth, and that'll bring in the veteran catcher Gary Sanchez. Here comes the 1-2. Swing and a line drive, but this is yanked down out there at shortstop for the first out. Stepping in once again is Gleyber Torres. He's 0-for-1 thus far. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And the pitch misses low and away for ball two. And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two.
Yeah, this is one of my biggest pet peeves in the game when guys get count leverage and take fastballs. It's a game of fastballs. You calibrate everything off the heater. Surprising take right there.
And he fouls this one off. Two runs on two hits and no errors for the Yankees so far. Fouled away. Another foul ball, and this battle will continue.
Hey, having AB right here, I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitches off, maybe one misses over the heart of the plate.
On pitch number 10 is the one that finally does it as he strikes out after a long battle here.
Third baseman, Gio.
1-2.
So you'd love for him to offer at that one, but the execution was flawless. Nice curveball that starts in the zone and breaks just out. Just a great take by the batter.
3-2, full count. He's ready. Now the payoff pitch. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Leading off the inning, it'll be Cesar Hernandez as they'll look to spark the offense and even things up. The 2-1.
Nope, that's
away. Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
3-2 now. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. And it's fouled away.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
The 3-2 one more time. And that misses for ball four. It's a leadoff walk that starts the bottom of the fourth.
Now batting.
So now
the
here is Jose Abreu,
Jose.
Grounded out in his last at bat.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result. That's his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
Now the 2-1 pitch.
Got to find a way to get back in the zone. I know you're in danger of losing both to walks, but certainly don't miss over the heart of the plate and have this guy gap one, or even worse, hit a two-run homer.
And boy, that misses as well. It's now back-to-back walks to start
baseman.
Out the inning.
Yoan Moncada.
Now the 1-1 pitch is swung on and missed for strike number two. Just hung in there on that one. Here he comes again, 1-2. Oh, and they pulled a string on a good changeup there as he swings and misses, and he's set down on strikes for the second time tonight.
The designated hitter, Aloy.
Now the 1-1 pitch.
What a well-executed fastball right there. Down and away. If you're going to do any damage with that pitch, you have to think up the middle the other way, and you have to be diving and leaning out over that thing.
To two balls and two strikes now. Back up the middle. Beautiful diving stop. There's one on to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Ronaldo Lopez, a 6'1" right-hander, will be the one to get the call from the bullpen here.
Ronaldo.
All ready to go in the top of the fifth. And up next, the left-handed hitting Brett Gardner. The 2-1 home. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two. Fouled off. Here's another 2-2. And he fouls this one off. To short. Anderson scoops it up. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away. Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. Now the 2-1. Hard on the ground towards short. Anderson picks it up. And that's the second out. And that'll bring up Aaron Judge. He started out the evening 0 for 2 so far. Fifth inning, 2-1 our score. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
And this is taken low for ball four, and they'll have themselves a two-out base runner here after all.
Now back. Left
next, here is Joey Gallo. And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. Fouled away. Judge is off of first with two away. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. The 2-2 one more time. In the dirt, and now let's see. Throw down to second here is by him and into center field. And he'll make it into scoring position here with two away, as that'll be scored a wild pitch. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. And he popped him up over toward the left side of the infield. And Moncada brings it in to retire the side. The batter will be Danny Mendick, 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Now the 1-1 pitch. Hit softly on the ground to third. Reined in. And quickly there's one down to lead off the frame. So one down, no one aboard. And up to the plate next is Andrew Vaughn. A 1-1 home. One run, just one hit, one error thus far for the White Sox. Hit in the air down the right field line. Judge is over near the line now as he makes the catch for the second out of the inning. Next batter to the plate, Brian Goodwin, worked the walk in his first plate appearance.
Goodwin.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And this is low, ball two, 2-1. Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. On the ground and right at the shifted infielders. Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and next the dangerous power threat, Giancarlo Stanton. The 1-1. Taken for strike two. Got him, and he goes down on strikes for the third time. Anthony Rizzo stands in now, head to head with Ronaldo Lopez. He's a 333 hitter, and it's fouled away. He'll try again. 1-2. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight.
Now batter.
Two away now in the Yankees' sixth. And the next to bat, the Dominican-born catcher Gary Sanchez. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. That's going to even up the count at 2-2.
It's going to be back to some serious tee work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
2-2 pitch is fouled away. Into the windup and the pitch. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. And now in the box, Zach Collins comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ball game. Now the 2-1 is in there for the second strike. Fastball laid off well below the knees.
It'd be great right here if he was able to work himself on base. You got the leadoff hitter on deck, and you know the middle of the order is coming up right behind him.
And that one misses, so the leadoff man will head down to first on ball four to start the bottom of the sixth.
Here, Anderson.
2-1 count to the Pale Hose leadoff hitter.
Down to 2-1.
Fastball, and looks like they're pinching him a bit here. It's 3-1.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Ground ball to second. This could be two. On to first, a double play. So base is empty now after the double play. And that'll give way to the veteran second baseman, Cesar Hernandez. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off.
Hey, this guy's got to be pretty proud of what he's done so far. It's never easy to pitch on the road, but to have this kind of outing in a ballpark that is notoriously known as being hitter friendly, it's been a treat to watch.
Fouled off. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone.
I don't blame the pitcher one bit for trying to get to Chase right there. He's been fouling everything off. He's still got the entire arsenal open to him. So we'll see what pitch he comes with next.
Now batting, first baseman, Jose Abreu.
At the plate, Jose Abreu. Called strike, and he's behind 1-2. Popped him up. Rizzo over to his left, and that will end the inning. Next up will be Gleyber Torres, head to head with Ronaldo Lopez, batting 500, 4-for-8. He also has one home run. Yankee shortstop behind in the count 1-2. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal, you can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Base hit, line drive into the corner. Around first, digging for two.
Now back, the third baseman, Gio Urshela.
Into the box now, Gio Urshela. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now. And he lays off a pitch off the plate and high, 3-2.
Going to need to make a little bit of an adjustment with his slider release and at least tempt the hitter that it's going to be a strike.
And this misses here for ball four. Just the second walk he's issued here into his seventh inning of work. Ready with the 1-1. And a fastball that misses up in the zone here. It's 2-1.
Hey, time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind an account with guys on base.
And that'll get on through into right field for a base hit. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late. Michael Kopech comes on now in an awfully difficult situation as there are two on here with nobody out. At the plate now, DJ LeMahieu swinging a ball hit softly on the ground. And he indeed takes only the out at first as the runners move to second and third with one away now. Here's big Aaron Judge. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. The set and the 1-1 pitch. Urshela on third. Gardner is over at second with one down in the inning. 2-2.
This is a situation where you're going strictly for the strikeout. Infield in, and from the offensive standpoint, you're just trying to create hard contact and get it by that infield.
There's a shin-high slider laid off for a ball. And this is swung on and missed, so they come right after him, and it remains second and third, but with two away now. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Waiting on it is Goodwin. And they'll avoid the big inning as he makes the catch. So just the one run scores here in the frame. Jonathan Loaisiga gets the call from the pen to take the ball for the home seventh.
Number 43.
Last half of the seventh here, and next will be the switch hitting third baseman, Yoan Moncada.
Always a tall task trying to rally back in the late innings, but I think this game could still turn quickly. A leadoff runner on base right here could be huge to get something going.
After it is Gardner. He's there and records the first down. To the plate now is the designated hitter, Emil Jimenez. He comes in 1 for 2 with that home run he hit earlier. Now one hit fouled over to the right side as the count moves to 1-2.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone. The 2-1. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Gardner is there, and he's got it for the final out of the frame. Ready to begin the eighth, and digging in is the veteran DH, Giancarlo Stanton. 1-1. It's a swing and a miss at a slider breaking away.
Can't say he's tickling around the zone. Those last two pitches were pretty much grooved right down the middle, but it didn't bite him.
And he'll strike out here yet again, as it's been a ball game to forget thus far. Baseman, four strikeouts. Here's the 3-2. Now Rizzo belts one, carrying well to right field. And out of here, and I mean by plenty. That ball was crushed. Into the box, Gary Sanchez. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
Now batting.
Next to dig in, Gleyber Torres. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. And this one misses here. A close pitch on 3-2, but Clyde Washington rules it ball four. Now into the box, Gio Urshela. It was a walk in his last trip. There's the 2-1 home. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
I wonder if that call not going his way right there has anything to do with walking the last guy. We all know umpires don't give you much on the corners if you're not throwing strikes consistently.
Goodwin finds some space out there for the catch to retire the side. Zach Britton is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 53, Zach.
Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and that'll bring forth the rookie outfielder, Andrew Vaughn. Here it comes on 1-1, and he fouls this one off. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And this is yanked hard down the left field line. And that's a fair ball as it'll head for the 330 sign near the bullpen. Throw into second. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
Now batting, the center fielder, Brian Goodwin.
To the plate now, Brian Goodwin dribbled down the third baseline. Once again a 3-2. And he misses there for ball four. So runners are at first and second now with nobody
up
out.
Next for the White Sox.
Next up, Zach Collins. It was a walk in his last trip. The 1-1 home. Hit down the line at first. Rizzo is there. To second for one. On to Rizzo at first, and they get them both. And now here is Tim Anderson.
The batter
in scoring
seven.
Position with Suzanne.
Shortstop, Tim Anderson.
Counts a ball and two strikes to the White Sox shortstop.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
Count even at 2-2. From the stretch. And a slider swung on and missed, and the side is retired. Ryan Tepera enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. So now into the box is Brett Gardner, a hit in two official trips to the plate to this point in the ballgame. The 1-2. And he turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. And it's gone as they add still another. In now, DJ LeMahieu pulled high in the air out to left field. Vaughn is there and he makes the catch for the out. Digging in now for the Yankees, Aaron Judge. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. Ready on 1-2. And that one misses badly. It's ball two. And there's ball three on a breaking ball that misses away. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
Up next for,
New York, Joey Gallo. He's got a hit in three at bats to this point. The 1-1.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
And he misses again, ball four, and that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on balls. And digging into the batter's box next will be Giancarlo Stanton. Been a really tough one on him. Already wearing the golden sombrero with four strikeouts. Swing and he takes this the other way to right. Mendick is there. Two down. And now Anthony Rizzo. He's got one hit in four at-bats.
That last at-bat, Nettie, the changeup right down the middle of the plate. Listen. This guy's got a great changeup, but he can't afford to keep throwing it middle like he did that last at bat.
There's a swing and a ball hit in the air, and a ball that he got every stitch of, as that one, without a doubt, is gone.
Ladies
Jose Ruiz enters now in a mop-up role as he'll try to keep the deficit the right where it is.
Number 66, Jose Ruiz.
At the plate, Gary Sanchez. And there's strike three. So we'll see now if they can manage to hold on to this huge lead as the side is retired. All set for the bottom of the ninth. And standing in is the switch hitting second baseman, Cesar Hernandez. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. Swing and a shot to third. But this will be speared at third, and that was self-defense all the way. One gone.
The first baseman.
Ready now for the White Sox. Jose Abreu. He's 0-for-2 thus far in this one. And a fastball misses there. Ball four. So here's the cleanup hitter, Yoan Moncada. 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. 1-1, here it comes. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. And he won't even think about second as he'll flip on to first for the sure out. Up next for Chicago, Eloy Jimenez. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat. Hit hard on the ground towards second. And that is through into center field, a base hit. And the run is in to score from second. It's now an 8-2 game.
Now batting, the right fielder, Geddy.
Stepping in now, Danny Mendick. Good pitch as this is swung on and missed. And now they're down to perhaps their final strike of the evening.
I think it's about time to choke up on that bat, get that foot down. He's awfully tardy right now.
Full count now. The White Sox down to their last strike. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Well, in hindsight, it was the right choice to let the setup guy stay in the game and finish this thing. I wasn't so sure before, but the results sure speak for themselves.
8-2 tonight's final. New York get the win on the heels of four home runs. Jordan Montgomery pitches well enough to get the W. Dylan Cease was only able to work four innings as he takes the loss. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Yankees, 8 runs, 7 hits, no errors. They left 7 men on base. For the White Sox, 2 runs on 4 hits, 1 error. They left 6 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 11 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please